Hello dear viewers, Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. So today the topic which I am going to present that is about cellular synthesis inhibitors. As we have discussed about the different type of antibiotics and its classifications, but today our topic is cellular synthesis inhibitors or beta lactam antibiotic. So as we know that why it is called beta lactam antibiotic, because if we study the structure, the structure activity relationships of beta lactam, so it contains beta lactam ring. Actually, for example, let's suppose penicillin. So penicillin is beta lactam antibiotic, which is also called cellular synthesis inhibitor. So if we can draw its structure, so there must be present a beta lactam ring. That's why it is called beta lactam antibiotic. Beta lactam ring, it may make the D-alanines and D-alanine portions of the peptide chain that is normally bound by penicillin protein bindings that assemble the peptidoglycan layer. So you can see here, this is periplasms and transpeptidase. This is called transpeptidase, which is the name of the enzymes. And now look at here, this is there is no peptide cross link here. Beta lactam antibiotics, so this prevent the cross linkage of the glycan strands leading to bacterial lysis. Come toward the basic classification of beta lactam antibiotic, which is divided into many classes. First one is penicillin, then cephalosporins, then carbapenems and monobacter. Penicillin include natural penicillin, so natural penicillin, that is penicillin G and penicillin V and benzathine P and procaine P. Penicillin V is variables orally, and penicillin G, this is a variable that can be administered to the patients in the form of injections. Penicillinase R, so these are the name of the enzymes which can act on the beta lactams ring. So penicillinase R include methicillin, nepsilin and cloxacillin. Another one is aminopenicillin, so aminopenicillin include amoxicillin, ampicillin. While the fourth one is extended spectrum, so extended spectrum is further divided into two, that is tricorsillin, tetracillin, and carbamazepine. Cephalosporin is further divided into five groups. The first one is first, second, third, and fourth PEP generations. The first generation cephalosporin, that is cepadroxins, cefalexin, cefuroxime, and cefazolin. While the second generation cephalosporin antibiotic, these are cepiclors, cepamendols, and cefuroxime and cefoxitins. While the third generation cephalosporins include cefotaxime, ceftazidime, and ceftriaxone. The only fourth generation antibiotic in cephalosporin, that is cefifines, while the fifth generation is ceftrorulines, as well as ceftobiprols. Okay, so another group is carbapenems. Carbapenems include amepenems, meropenems, and etapenems. Another one is monobactam. So monobactam is aspirinems. Okay, dear students, come toward the spectrum of activity of penicillin. So as we know that penicillin is a boss. This is beta lactamases, cellular synthesis inhibitors. Okay, now let's see here natural penicillin. So natural penicillins, these are the antibiotics which are active against gram-positive bacteria like streptococci and monocytogenes and some anaerobes and some spirochetes. As well as some of them, they are active against gram-negative, that is called pneumococcal meningitis and some Helicobacter influenza. While penicillin is also they are active against Streptococcus aureus, Staphylococcus aureus and Streptococcus epidermidis. Another one is aminopenicillin. So aminopenicillin is similar to the natural penicillins with additional gram negative. So it also show some activity against gram negative. For example, there is Escherichia coli and Mimira bellus and Streptococcus enterica and Shigella species, etc. Another one is aminopenicillin B, that is called beta lactamase inhibitor. So actually it includes the sulbactam and clavulanate, clavulanic acid, which can actually it can inactivate the beta lactamase and burden the aminopenicillin activity. So in simple words, we can say that the sulbactams and clavulanic acid, so it can actually inactivate the beta lactamase, which are the enzymes, and it can burden the aminopenicillin activity. Streptococcus aureus, many enterobacteria, especially Clostridia, except difficile and bacterial sardine species. The extended spectrum activity they show against Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So these are the different type of microorganisms, and with these antibiotics they are used. Okay, another spectrum of activity, now look at your spectrum of activity of cephalosporin. So each successive generation has broader activity against aerobic gram negative. So there is limited activity against anaerobes, and they lack activity against L monocytogenes and enterococcus. The first generation's cephalosporin, so it can covers good coverage for aerobic gram-positive cocci like streptococci and staphylococci, and some gram-positive, some of them they are active against gram-positive. It means that the gram first generation antibiotic can show classical activity against aerobic gram-positive bacteria. The second generation cephalosporins, which we have already discussed, so the second generation antibiotic, it can increase the activity against aerobic gram negative and facultative, like Escherichia coli and P. mirabilis and H. influenza and B. fragilis. The third generations, in addition, they are against actual activity against Burgdorferi and greater activity against aerobic gram negative in second generation, and short lived activity against enterobacteria. No activity against Pseudomonas aeruginosa except Septizidimes. As we know that there are different type of antibiotics, first, second, third and fourth in PEP generation. So how we can differentiate between all these groups on the basis of spectrum of activities? So if I can mention that the gram positive activity of third generation that is greater than first generation, yes, this is right, that the gram negative activity of third generation that is better than first generation and second generations. And then if we compare the spectrum of activity between third generation, fourth and fifth generation, so then the fourth and fifth generations, and you can say its activity will be greater than third generation. So on the basis of that we can differentiate. So third generations it show greater activity against gram negative than as compared to the second generation, which is short-lived activity against enterobacteria, and there is no activity against Pseudomonas aeruginosa except Cephalosporins. While the fourth and fifth generation, so it show a good anti-pseudomonals and anti-staphylococcus coverings, and there also you can say enterobacteriaceae. Okay, dear students, come to where the main group, carbapenems. What are carbapenems? As we know that, So carbapenem, so that belong to beta-lactamases. Beta-lactam antibiotic because beta-lactam ring is present in its structure. So carbapenem is a very broad spectrum gram-positive and negative anaerobes. Due to a small molecule with charge characteristics that allow them to use purines, especially purines which are present in the outer membrane of the gram-negative bacteria, which can easily access to the penicillin-binding proteins. While carbapenems, they also show resistance to beta-lactamases. Carbapenems also show some affinity to the broad range of penicillin-binding proteins. Okay, dear students, another one is monobactam. So monobactam is another class of antibiotic which is also called S2N. So this is the group member of the monobactams which come under the category of beta-lactam antibiotics. So monobactam show a very good gram negative curve. For example, Neisseria gonorrhea and Haemophilus species intermediates on the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So it's a poor activity and gram positive anaerobe. There is no cross reaction in beta-lactam allergy. Especially those patients who are allergic to penicillins, to beta-lactam, to this group, so he or she can change, he can use alternate brand. Another one is silvalcin, synthesis in a better, that is vancomycin. So look at the structure. MAG, MAG, and NAG, and acetyl glucosamines. Okay, so we'll discuss about silvalcin in a better. So vancomycin is another drug like beta-lactam antibiotic. So it binds to the DL-alanine portion of the peptidoglycan layer. In this peptidoglycan layer, so what it can prevent the penicillin binding proteins from adding them to the peptidoglycan layer. They are effective against nearly all the aerobes which can survive in the presence of oxygen, and anaerobes gram positive including Klebsiella or difficiles, and no activity on gram negative. Emerging resistance, it shows emerging resistance against enterococci. Okay, so another group of antibiotic that is called antibiotic that inhibit the protein synthesis. Inshallah, we will discuss about the protein synthesis inhibitor in my next lecture. Thank you so much for watching my lecture. So if you have any questions, so you can ask me. I'm always available for my services. Thank you.